Well, that's what we were supposed to have. Hey guys, Raider here. Hope you're all doing great and having a fantastic day. Today I want to share the latest news with you guys about Intel's Arc dedicated GPU. This has been in the works since 2020. It came out briefly in South Korea. When I mean briefly, I mean just for a few hours, really. On one laptop and one laptop only on March 30th, and that was a Galaxy Book 2 Pro, the non-360 version. This is a 360 here. The retail price on that when it launched was about $2,100 US, so basically about $550 more than this one for the dedicated GPU. It was also shown on a few US websites for a brief time, like B&H Photo. Customers were able to order it, and instead they received the Intel Iris Xe edition like we have here. So a lot of customer complaints. Needless to say, those listings were quickly pulled. You know, and the strangest thing about it too, guys, is that this is a brand new product offering for Intel, right? Brand new. They've been talking about this since 2020. They've been pushing for a March 30th, 2022 release worldwide. We only got it in one market. And they came out swinging with their weakest product offering, the A350M, which comes in at a clock speed of 1150 megahertz. This is the weakest of all the ARC offerings. And that's what they come out swinging with in one model for a brief period of time. And the reason that it only came out for a short period of time is because the performance was abysmal. I'm going to link a video that I want you guys to check out if you have a little time. It's from Gamers Meld, and he covers some of the benchmark scores, and I think it's pretty hilarious that they're averaging 60 FPS in Overwatch, and I'm going to show you guys some footage now of the FPS that I'm getting on Overwatch with the integrated graphics that are in the 360 Pro. You can see here, I'm averaging right around 70 frames per second. So with the integrated Intel Iris Xe graphics, I'm literally averaging 10 frames per second more than what you're getting with the dedicated GPU ARC offering that Intel put out on the South Korean model for a short period of time. That's why they pulled it, because it couldn't even compete with integrated graphics. You know, they touted all the features, the ray tracing, the scaling and shading and all these great things that it can do. And the drivers are so bad that it can't even keep up with basic gameplay that we can get with integrated graphics. You can see here in the latest reports coming out, and these started circulating this morning, that Intel Arc is being pushed out to mid-2022 at the very earliest. So for those of you that have been holding out for the Galaxy Book 2 Pro, the non-360 version, just to get your hands on the Intel Arc graphics, it's not happening. It's not happening anytime soon. Maybe a few months from now we might see it, but I'll tell you what, I don't want to be the test guinea pig for it. Not based on the benchmarks we're seeing. It really has just turned out to be a very pathetic release. And I'm just baffled that they would come out swinging with the lowest product offering that they have. That is not something you would expect Intel to do when trying to compete with AMD and NVIDIA. Even though this whole release thing with the Intel Arc graphics has been abysmal, thankfully we're still getting pretty good performance out of the Intel Iris Xe graphics. It is possible to get above 60 frames per second, even though this is only a 60 hertz screen, especially when you're connected to an external monitor, and that's why I've got everything hooked up right now. I'm going to show you guys a setting that you can adjust, and this is how I was able to get over 60 frames per second in Overwatch. Those of you that have been gaming for a long time, I'm sure you already know how to do all this, but for those of you that are getting into it, or are just now considering your first laptop or using a laptop with an external display, let me show you guys something real quick. Just right click on your desktop, you're gonna go to display settings, and you'll see here we have multiple displays hooked up, right? So if we go down here, we can adjust the resolution. You can go ahead and pick it to be whatever your maximum is for your connected display. In my case, it's a 1440p QHD monitor. But however, if you leave it at the default 1920 by 1080 setting, you can go down here to advanced display. All right, you have two options. There's going to be display one, which is the internal display. This is always going to be locked at 60 hertz. You can't do anything about that. It's a 60 hertz panel only. But if you pick your external display, you'll see here that you have all the refresh options available to you as long as you're picking 1080p. I'm connected to this Anchor USB-C hub via HDMI to my monitor. So HDMI is gonna have that locked at 144 max as opposed to the 165 on the display port. But you'll see here if I go back a screen and we switch the resolution to be 1440 and go back to the advanced display, you'll see here on display two, we now only have the close to 60 hertz option, 59.95. So something to keep in mind, if you want to do 1080p at high refresh rate, you do have the option on the Galaxy Book Pro 360 and any of the other Galaxy Books as well. So guys, I'm sorry to bring the bad news. It's just not happening for Intel Arc. Even when this stuff does come out, I would be very, very hesitant in being an early adopter just based on the fact that they're coming out with the weakest model out of the gate. It was supposed to be released worldwide on March 30th. We saw it in one model in South Korea. And because they're shelving it until mid to late 2022, because it's just not meeting benchmarks that gamers are expecting. So for now, we're stuck with the integrated graphics. I've been happy with them on this laptop. Again, it's not a gaming machine. I know that's what you guys were wanting to do with the discrete art graphics, but it's just not happening for the time being. You'll have to consider another laptop for gaming. All right, guys, as always, thanks for watching.